before he became president or even went into politics, opened up a general store with a friend. Well, his friend wasn't good with money, and they went bankrupt. And the friend took off, but Abraham Lincoln stayed there, and he took him 15 years to pay off all the debts. He promised that he would be faithful to the debts that the business incurred. 15 years he worked and paid off that debt. There's another interesting story that I came across in the Georgia Blue Collar Bulldogs had a basketball game. It was a playoff, and they won. But then the coach went back and he looked at the roster and he said, "Oh my goodness, we got the trophy, but I put a player in that shouldn't have been playing because he was ineligible." And he only played 45 seconds in the game. Now, what would you do if you were the coach? Well, it's only 45 seconds, you know, nobody's going to really know. But he was a man of honesty. And he went to the commissioners and he said, "We accidentally put a player in that was ineligible. He only played for 45 seconds. And so they lost the trophy. They gave it up. They came in second." To have a reputation of doing what is right. You know, even today, a lot of times it's hard to do what's right. Let's face it. Things are so confusing. People aren't getting along. And thank goodness, not to get political, but there's a 45-day reprieve on the budget. Because the people that would get hurt very badly are those on food stamps and also in the military. And this is what gets me so angry so many times, is that 1% of our population protects us. But yet, 30% of those serving in the military are military families have less than $3,000 in their bank account. Did you know the Coast Guard is paid by the Homeland Security? And they would have been without a paycheck. Doing what's right for those persons that are in trouble. It's important for us to do those things what are right. Bill Gaither, the famous singer, wanted to buy some property in the town that he grew up, and he went to a farmer that had several thousand acres. And the man, Bill Gaither, went to this old gentleman, and he said, "I'd like to buy 15 acres for $3,800. He said, "Would it be possible?" He said, "Well, I can't do that because I want to keep it as a farm. I don't want you to build a house on there and, you know, a little homestead." But then Bill Gaither mentioned his grandfather that worked for this man. And once he mentioned his grandfather, he said, "You know, he was a man of honor and he was a great employee. I'm going to give you those 15 acres for $3,800. Because of the reputation of the grandfather." Well, you know, this is Worldwide Communion Sunday, and it's a sacrament with Christians throughout the world. And it would be a good time for us to reflect on the promises we have made to God. As I was coming in, it was kind of pointed out to me that Bryce Harper had a rough week with baseball. He got mad during the game. He took his helmet, he was telling the referee off, he threw his helmet into the crowd. And this little boy got the helmet and returned it to Bryce Harper, and the little boy, or maybe the father, wrote this on the helmet. Luke 1, verse 37, "For nothing will be impossible with God." Whoa. Can you believe that? That little kid had that and gave it back to Bryce Harper. Well, you know, we do get angry at times, all of us. But as on this Worldwide Communion Sunday, the promises we have made with God, we have to keep. And are these new promises we should make today? Are there any new promises? Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for our scripture lessons this morning. Questioning the authority of Jesus Christ, and also the parable of the two sons. As we partake of Holy Communion, let us keep the promises that we have made. For we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Holy Communion is on page 12 in our hymnal. I hope everyone picked up their little communion cups. People have been asking me about that. You know, we're going to go back to we have communion in the little cups and the bread. But the bishop is still kind of firm on us using these little cups and the bread. As you know, the shots are out for the flu and for COVID, and there's another one. And last Sunday, I took two of them at the same time. Well, Monday, I wasn't feeling too good. Just a warning, that was me, not you. You too? Okay. So be careful. But this is the way we should have communion, just to be on the safe side. Well, let us look at our communion service this morning. You know, in the communion service, there's an invitation. We invite everyone to partake of Holy Communion. We have open communion in the Methodist Church. Open communion means that if your heart, if you're searching for Christ, you're welcome. And even if you don't have it all together, maybe there's questions about the Christian faith. I want to explore it, but you are invited during this invitation. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who earnestly repent of their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen.
The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy are you and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of the suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. At this time, Jesus was sitting down with his disciples in the upper room just hours before he would be arrested, brought in before the crowd, condemned to die on the cross, arise from the grave 3 days later, spent 40 days with us and then ascended into heaven and is preparing a place for us, an eternal home at this tough time. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread. Broke the bread. Gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples, and said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ offered for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and of these gifts and bread and wine, make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. Amen. And now with us, with the confidence of children of God, let us all pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The body of Christ given for you. Amen. The blood of Christ given for you. Amen. Our next hymn is hymn number 79. Let us stand. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen.